Welcome back, gang. So now that we have some buttons set up, what I would like to do is add loading states to them, and I want to use some spinners to help us do that. One of the new, well, I don't know if it's new, but it's new to me, is this Epic Spinners website, which have a load of different spinners that you can use, and they're just little components that you put into your project. Okay, I'll leave the link for this in the description so that you can just click it and go check it out. Okay, but to start using it, we are going to go to get started, and then we're going to go ahead and install it in the project. Okay, we'll open up another terminal. And then we will go ahead and let that install. Okay, now that that's finished installing, we will go back to the documentation. And they have different ways of using it here. But first I want to pick the one that I want, which we'll go back to gallery. And it's going to be this fingerprint one. So we'll go ahead, tap to view. And then you'll pick the Vue.js one, okay? And this will be the information that we're using. Now, I've already copied and pasted it and set it up to the sizes that I want. So I'm just going to go ahead and do that, and then we will continue on. The first thing that we want to do is add a loading state to our data section. So we're going to have loading is false. So it'll already be set to false when we start. Okay, and then head up and let's try putting it in here first. Okay, we're going to add it right below, right in the opening. So paste. Okay, and all it is just giving it animation duration. It's pretty self-explanatory. Animation duration, we're giving it a size and we're just adding text white to it. Okay, let's bring that up. Now we need to add the loading state. So it'll be loading equals v if loading. Okay, now around the text we're going to add another template. Open that up, and we are going to put these two lines up into the template. Okay, so now it'll be V if loading, and then here we'll have V else. Okay, so now we need to import the spinner into the app. Well, I'm going to do that by just adding it in right here. Okay, and we need to now bring this into our list of components. Comma. So now to bring it into the method, we'll scroll down, and the first one will be add friend. So here we'll put this loading equals true, and then on success in here, we'll put this loading equals false. Okay, so let's give it a try. I can close this up now. Let's go to our browser and see if it works. We can close this out also. So refresh. Okay, we'll try and click add friend. And there it is, it stopped. So now we can go ahead and add it to our other relationships. So to make things easy, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to change this to the requester with the ID of 1 and then requester ID of 7. Okay, and let's go and refresh this again so we can get the other buttons. Okay, so let's start with the accept button. So we'll go back to our code. And we'll go to the accept component. Okay, We'll go ahead and put it under here. Oh. And slide that over. Break that up. And then we'll add a template. Okay, bring these two up. And we'll add the else. Okay, and then from the status component, we'll just grab the imports. So it's going to be this one. Copy back, import it here, and then what was the other one? This one, copy, accept, and we'll add it here. Okay, so we'll also add our loading state. So loading equals false. Okay, accept friend. So once that is clicked, this loading equals true. And then on success, this loading equals false. Okay, so now we can go ahead and do the same thing in the next one. We'll take this out. We'll put it in our ignore button. Go up. Okay, we'll add it here. And then again, template. Bring these two up. We'll add the else. We'll bring in the import. So accept. Copy. Ignore. Paste. Bring that down. Okay, and then copy. Paste. Okay, so ignore request. We'll add this loading equals false, or I'm sorry, we need to add that data property too. This loading equals false, open this up. This loading equals true or false. Okay, so we need the data property, so data. Return loading is false. Not a comma there. Okay, and before I forget, we need to do it in one other place, which is the delete. Okay, so go up here. Yeah, under in that danger button, jet danger button. So we'll copy, go to unfriend. Okay, we'll add template, open, bring these two lines up. And in the template, we're giving it a VLS. Okay, go down, go down, go down. We already have the imports. Oh, this, yeah. Go down. This loading equals true. And on success, this loading equals false. Okay, and we won't have to worry about conflicts for this because the add friend and the delete friend buttons aren't displayed at the same time. Okay, so let's try these out. Refresh. Okay, so now we can go ahead and click accept. Okay, and now we have unfriend, and we can click that, and that spinner will work there too. Okay, fantastic. Alrighty, I think that's it for me today. Thanks again for watching, guys. I really do appreciate it, and I hope you guys are getting something out of these videos. I'm gonna go ahead, push this code up to GitHub. Go ahead, like, and subscribe if you want, and then I will see you guys next episode. Thanks again for watching.